According to the Islamic faith, Muslims are not allowed to exchange money which has interest attached to it. On the other side, the parish development model, which is a government initiative to extend startup money to Ugandans at the parish level, has a 0.5% interest rate.
I would like also to appeal to government on parish development model. I would like to urge government to consider the Muslim all over the country also to be beneficiaries in this very important fund that will bring change into their life.
Sheikh Musa Khalil is the Northern Regional Assistant to the Mufti of the Uganda Muslim Supreme Council. Speaking after the Eid prayers on Friday, he is strongly advocating for the government of Uganda to think of ways that the Muslims can also benefit from the parish development without impeding on the values of their religion. Interest incurred on borrowed money is known as riba in Islam, and it is forbidden.
As in Islam, it contradicts with our faith, because it has some interest, and no interest in Islam is totally not allowed. And in Islam, we have a very clear scripture talking about the interest. Once you have taken any wealth out of interest, you have opened the battle with Almighty. And I don't think anybody wish to open, anybody can win that battle.
The argument is that religion should not stop the government from giving support to its citizens.
Where other communities are suffering from poverty, that does not leave the Muslim community out of it.
That Muslim, if they are getting money, they don't pay back with the interest, they should understand that. Then lastly, the government is still piloting this. This project is very good, but I think they are still piloting it. That's why most of the people are not getting this in the community.
Under the parish development model, 17 million shillings is available for each parish across the country. The Muslim leaders believe that it is high time that the government included their faithful in the poverty alleviation program.
This development model, they are borrowings with interest which intrigue into the Islamic values. Then lastly, I also appeal to government on the Islamic banking system, which will also help the Muslim to come out of poverty.
While Reverend Nelson Obol, the Gulu City Provisional Overseer of the Born Again Churches, calls on the concerned authorities to listen to the Muslim leaders.
If their faith says that they can't take money and then at the end of the day pay back with a little bit of interest, then I think government should come up with something. Give people, all the Christians, the Muslims, money that is not to be refunded. Money that they can, of course, improve with their livelihoods.
However, Reverend Nelson Obol further encourages Muslims who wish to get the PDM money to register as the government looks for other alternatives. The Badege Laibi female youth counselor, Lake Becky Oweka, is asking for the Muslim hierarchy in the country to involve the office of the president.
Our brothers and sisters in the Muslim community should bring in different means to lobby for a different grant from the government, because the government is able and the government is inclusive. They consider every religion.
The parish development model hopes to reduce the number of Ugandans living on less than $1 a day. This population is estimated at 39%, which surely does not exclude Muslims. I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.